Hi guys, are you planning to restart your factory or your construction site after the lockdown? Are you scared of spread of coronavirus among your staff or your workers at your factory and your site? Or do you feel that travel of your workers and your staff every day to the factory or the site is a big challenge and a huge cost to you right now? If your answer is yes for any of these questions, then please watch this video till the end, because I will give you good pointers on how to reduce the risk of spread of coronavirus at your site or your factory by over 75%. Yes guys, reducing the risk by over 75%. I'm Nikhil Bothra, director at EPAC Group. Let's face it guys, we all are scared. It's a big challenge for us right now. We all are scared what will happen if even a single case appears in our factory or our site. Maybe our factory or our site would be sealed for weeks. What will happen to the asset utilization? What will happen to the cash flows? What will happen to the EBITDA margins? Yes, guys, these are big questions and we don't know what will happen to it. But what we know is that yes, the virus is there and we have to take necessary measures to reduce the risk of spread of coronavirus. So let's jump on it. How can we do it? Look at the fact, what WHO or the world-renowned doctors have said. Currently, since the vaccination is not available, social distancing is the best and the only possible way to keep yourselves away from coronavirus. So if we are starting a factory or a site, we'll have maybe hundreds of workers and staff coming in and going out every day, right? And they go out, they go to the cities, they go to their houses, they meet a lot of people, and then there are chances that they might get coronavirus. So, to reduce the risk of coronavirus, we have to reduce their social exposure. He says that if we reduce our social exposure by 75%, the risk of getting coronavirus again reduces by 75%. So, how can we reduce the social exposure of our staff and workers? The only possible way is by giving them good and sustainable living environment within the site and within our factory premises to keep our staff and our workers within the boundaries. Maybe we can use the roof to create extra floor. Maybe we can utilize the extra space available and create good sustainable infrastructure. Now the question is, how do we do it so quickly and what is the impact of the costing? How much investment do we need in it? Yes, that's a big question. We are doing an investment. For a construction site or an infrastructure site, they have to choose a technology which they can reuse and relocate at every site for long term. So for short term, it can reduce the risk of corona, and for long term, it can be a very good and productive asset. For the factories, we have to get a good environment where later we can use it as store buildings or for accommodations or for store purposes or for any possible other requirements that we might have. Now let's look at the costing. Yes guys, so once we have chosen the right technology, once we have pinned down what we need, which is the best technology, which is quick, which is easy to clean, and which is liftable and shiftable and relocatable, then we have to look at the costing. Yes guys, we have to be sure that we don't invest too huge and not able to utilize that asset. That has to be taken care of. Other part which we need to look at is the entry of the material within the site. So whenever any material or a truck or a small tempo comes in, we have to use a disinfectant tunnel. The truck will go through that. We have to disinfect the cabins and the material with disinfectant. We have to have a tunnel at the entry gate for our staff and workers for the first time when they're entering, and then they'll be deputed at the site. And we have to have a separate isolation rooms and a separate area wherein the guest will come and they will stay and they will not interact with the staff inside staff. So that restriction has to be maintained. The proper health checkup and proper sanitization rules have to be maintained at the entry point for all the people coming in. And we have to make sure that anyone who is coming in the site is not allowed to travel throughout the site or the factory, and they are restricted to a particular location which is isolated. So if we keep our staff and our workers within the boundary wall, if we sanitize the material and the people, restrict the movement of the people coming in, we sanitize them properly, and we possibly reduce as much as entry of people coming in, then yes guys, we can reduce the risk of possible sealing of our factory and our site. So let's get on it. Let's try to do it as soon as possible. A lot of people are already doing, a lot of good companies have already started exploring options and started construction within the premises. So let's not delay it. Let's be proactive and save ourselves from this virus. If you need any further details, please contact me or my team at the below given mobile number or the email ID, and we'll be happy to help you out. Thank you so much for watching, guys.